with six laps to go in the 10,000 metres, four athletes have broken right away from the nearly 50 who started. Di Costello, the Commonwealth Games marathon champion from Australia, in front. Charlie Spedding, who represented Britain in both European and Commonwealth Games last year, in second place from Gateshead. In third place, Jeff Smith of Liverpool Harriers. And in fourth place at the moment, Alistair Hutton of Scotland, who made a break in the early part of the race, but failed to sustain it. And the Australian, so powerful, so tough, brought the field back to him. A word from Brendan Foster, who's won this title himself twice before.
I know that Di Costello came over from Australia just for the 3A's championships before he en route to Helsinki, but he did say that he felt he would like to get towed around in a time faster than 28 minutes. Unfortunately, he finds himself at the front and they're slipping behind 28 minute pace, and it looks like Steve Binns, who's run 27.55 for the 10,000 metres, he'll be selected for the comp for the World Championships, because nobody's going to run faster than that tonight, I don't think.
Steve Binns, by the way, was entered for this race, and he's watching in the stands. He elected not to run. Two men already chosen are Nick Rose and Steve Jones. They're not running in this event tonight either. Steve Binns elected to watch, so these athletes would be looking to do something inside 27.55, which Steve Binns has already clocked. But really, they've been outside that schedule, Brendan, all the way.
Well, they've never quite gone on terms with the race, and Julian Gota, who is one of the leading contenders for the 10,000 meter place, slipped behind very badly early on and hasn't run very well tonight. But looking at the leaders there, Di Costello looks strong. Charlie Spedding's running quite well tonight, which is good for him because he had a bad run in Oslo and he was very disappointed with that. And in third place, Jeff Smith, who's had a terrible season caused through serious injuries to his calf muscle, was torn apart in a race recently. And Alistair Hutton's run well early, because he broke away, looked as though he was going comfortably, and then all of a sudden got hauled in. So it's now between these four, and I think the main contenders could be Duke Di Costello, could be the two British boys, Jeff Smith and Charlie Spedding.
So just checking back through the field, Julian Gota appears to have dropped out. He may well try in the 5,000 tomorrow, for which he has a qualifying time for the World Championship. But Julian's had a bad season, in fact, because he's had infected sinus problems, which only just really been sorted out, but did affect his training. Coming round now with four laps to go. The Australian, who really is the favourite for the marathon in the World Championship, leading Charlie Spedding, who's having one of his best runs for nearly 12 months, there's no question about that. Jeff Smith still in third place. In fourth place, Alistair Hutton. And then we've got to go a long way back to Adrian Leake of Cardiff, who is in fifth place. Woods of Liverpool in sixth place. But there's so many athletes strung out now around the track, it's difficult to place them. Ray Smedley, the marathon runner from Birchfield, taking that lot through. That's Carl Harrison from Stretford. That's someone who was up with the leaders early on. Colin Moore of Bingley wearing 30. And coming through now, Kevin Foster, the cross-country international, wearing the vest of Gateshead, which he's recently joined.
And that's the leading group again. Di Costello is really starting to grind the pace out now with four laps. They're coming up with four laps to go, and this is the point where 10,000 meters really starts to hurt. It doesn't matter what pace you've run up to this point, the race is going to be won from now till the finish, obviously, but your stomach starts to turn over and you start to feel tiredness in your legs. And there's Charlie Spedding just making a break. He's got a lot of support here. They've all come down from various events from the northeast, and Charlie's been building up for a good one. And I'm delighted to see him take it on this early, because he knows the pace isn't fast enough to qualify him, so he's going to have to do something about it. But Jeff Smith responded very, very quickly, looks very comfortable, poised right on Charlie's shoulder there.
Well, it's a courageous bit by Charlie Spedding. He's gone very, very early indeed, and he's failed to break Jeff Smith, who's moving quite freely behind him. Alistair Hutton's off the pace now, and so too is Di Costello. But it's a very, very early break indeed, and the pace has been so slow at the moment, with four laps to go on our last check, that we're running on course for something like 28.20, but of course in these closing stages now, they'll obviously speed up.
Actually, when you make a break like that, what you always hope that the guy behind you is going to drop, and Charlie's now worrying because he hasn't dropped Jeff Smith sufficiently. He's going to have to go into a second burst and start really stretching it. And there's runners getting in the way there, and maybe that's just enough to give Charlie the extra impetus to push it on along and go for his first ever title.
Just as you were talking then, Brendan, he did make the bid, and he has started to break Jeff Smith. It coincided actually with him going through tired athletes, but in fact Charlie had got away then, and it's not surprising because he's just done a 63-second lap. I know Brendan still trains with Johnny Spedding quite a bit.
Unexpected? A little bit unexpected. I mean, I don't train with him at that pace these days, 63 seconds, and that's obviously why he's pulled away from Jeff Smith, because they both looked as though they were straining, and it wasn't until the lap time showed at 63 seconds that we could realise why. Now, Charlie's got a bit of confidence from that burst. He's got a winning gap if he can only just drive himself over the last two laps. And this is hard. It's hard for Jeff Smith, and it's hard for Charlie. But when Charlie's leading, it's a little bit easier for him. He keeps glancing over his shoulder. He's bound to be suffering because of that 63-second lap, because that's pretty quick for Charlie. But there he is. There's two laps to go, or one lap to go in the 3A's championships. Charlie Spedding.
And Charlie could be on the way to a famous victory. Some 20 Gateshead clubmates down in front of us, roaring him on, and he's got 30 metres to spare. He really only hit the international scene when he was 30 last year. He's now 31. He was fourth in the Commonwealth Games 10,000 and eighth in the European 10,000. You could call him a late developer in many ways, but my word, this is the night of his life, because the 3A's title looks to be on the way back to Gateshead. He's now got some 40 metres on Jeff Smith, with Alistair Hutton in third place, Di Castella fourth, and the rest a long way back. Just under 200 metres to go. Jeff Smith really is suffering. Alistair Hutton there too. Stella in fourth place. The rest are lapped. And so the stand rises to acclaim what looks to be a certain win for a very tired Charlie Spedding. Threading his way through on the inside. The lap runners having the courtesy to let him through as he comes through to take the 1983 10,000 metre title. Back to that famous club in the North East. The personal best performance with Jeff Smith in second place, Alistair Hutton third, Di Castella fourth. And the time, 28 minutes, 7.79 seconds, a personal best. He takes the title, but I'm afraid he will not make the trip to the World Championship. But this is marvellous compensation for him, and that was a brave run to take it on in the way he did, and he got it exactly right.
But if you look at his face when he crossed the line, there's no disguising his tiredness. He's now trying to recover and trying to muster a smile. But nobody minds hurting when they're winning the 3A championships. And you know, the selection thing is an issue, because you know that Charlie Spedding, if he went to the World Championships, he's a solid runner. He's the kind of runner who's always going to produce a performance. But I think probably Steve Binns did enough in Oslo by beating him to earn his selection for the World Championships. But what a great way to be compensated by winning a 3A title.